It seems these days that everyone wants to be a YouTuber. Whether or not you want it to be your main thing, if you want to be super famous on YouTube, or maybe you just thought about opening up a YouTube channel just on your favorite hobby and just doing it for fun. And I fall into that category too, which is why I started making YouTube videos consistently about a year and a half ago. I've been grinding to make sure I put out at least one video a week for the last year and a half. And that might not sound like a lot to you, but it's pretty time consuming, and especially when you're not getting paid at all for this. And now I'm happy to say that I'm almost to the point where I can monetize. Now, before, I thought the only requirement was that you had to have 1,000 subscribers. So when I got 1,000, I was like, yes, finally, like, let's go. This is a huge milestone. And yes, the number is a huge milestone, but then I go and look and it's like, oh, that's the first requirement. And then the other requirement was that you have to have 4,000 public watch hours within a year. And that has slowed me down drastically. I'm almost at 2,000 subscribers at the point of making this video. And I think one of the reasons is that I pride myself on making mostly short videos because I don't want to waste anyone's time. I try and keep the tutorials as quick and to the point as possible, which many people have commended me for. I don't want to change that for anything. I'm not trying to make 20-minute videos that could be two. If it's a long video and needs to be, then it can be. And unfortunately, that doesn't necessarily directly translate into more people watching my videos. So at the time of making this video, I am 4 hours short of hitting that 4,000 watched hours. Now on the YouTube app on my phone, it said that I was over 4,000 watched hours, but a few months ago, I decided to run one of my tutorials as an ad just to get it out there to more people because I was like, you know what, like I'm not selling anything to anyone, and that wouldn't even be wrong if I was, but I'm just trying to spread the knowledge and hopefully get more people to see my channel and stick around. And so that gave me a handful of watch hours, and apparently those don't count, which is hilarious because when I was on the phone with the ad guy who works for Google or YouTube, same thing, he was like, oh yeah, this might actually help you get to that monetization point earlier. No, you don't even know what you're talking about, sir. So if you're trying to get your channel monetized, just know there are no shortcuts. It's just hard work. Making these YouTube videos can be a bit of a sacrifice sometimes. It's a Sunday, my family's all eating dinner and whatnot. I stopped by for an hour or two and then said, yeah, I gotta go home, I gotta make a YouTube video. I can't not have one ready. And it's often pretty hard to even find time to make the videos because you're juggling both work and a social life and working out and all those things. And it's really funny because I'm like really pumped to be monetized, but I'm pretty sure at best, given my stats right now, I'll be making like $500 to $600 a year. And I got that number by using that Social Blade website. If you've never checked it out, it's actually pretty amusing going on there to like look at whoever your favorite creators are and see how much money their channel might be pulling in every year. It's pretty crazy. Some are super high, and then when you look up your own, you're like, oh, that's sad. And it's not all about the money, but you know, it's been that next goal that I've been working towards. So it's on my mind because that is the next milestone. And it's crazy too because, you know, the first requirement is 1,000 subscribers. And right now, I'm a few short from 2,000. That's how long it took to get monetized past the 1,000 subscriber point. And it's kind of unfortunate too, because they say they have these requirements for you to qualify for the monetization, but then they're still putting ads on my most successful videos that are getting tens of thousands of views. And I'm just like, like, why is it cool for you to do that and then not, you know, tell me I can't qualify yet? It's kind of frustrating, but at the same time, YouTube didn't have to give us creators any slice of the pie. They could have just made a platform for us to share videos with people. So, guess I can't be too upset. And with all that, I just want to say thank you. Thank you if you're watching this video. Thank you if you just subscribed. Thank you if you've been a subscriber and supporter for years. I appreciate every single one of you. And hearing all the great things that people have to say about how helpful some of my tutorials are and how much they've taken away from it, I love that feeling. Because that's how I got to do what I'm doing now, is I learned from YouTube, didn't need school. I get asked that all the time. I never went to school for videography, photography, VFX, nothing. It was all because of YouTube, because people wanted to make educational videos and share them for free. So thank you everyone. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one.